after this local leader phase, the phase is global leader phase. So in this global leader phase, the solution is updated using this equation subject to this probability. In the local leader phase, the solution was updated with the help of probability PR, and this time it is with the help of this probability, 0.9 multiplied by the current fitness divided by the maximum fitness plus 0.1, right? So with the help of this probability, this solution is updated based on this equation. So let me just explain this equation. What does it mean? So new solution equal to the old solution plus the random number between 0 and 1. This GLJ is the global leader. This GLJ is the global leader means best solution of the entire population. This is the current solution plus this is a random number between -1 and +1, a randomly selected solution, and this is the current solution. This is the current solution. So here you can see that this term is same as the local leader phase. This term is same as the local leader phase, where the current solution is again inspired by the randomly selected member of the entire population. This time this R is selected from the complete population, and here this GLJ is the best solution of the swarm, So here you can see that the, of course, the coefficient will be, since this GLJ is better or equal to this current solution, and therefore this coefficient is always positive, and the direction is always from SM to G. This is the direction, and which is the required direction also. So here you can see that in this phase, the solution is updated based on a randomly selected member of the entire swarm and the best member of the entire swarm based on this probability. Let me just explain, through algorithm also. Oh, okay, of course, sorry. This algorithm is not here in this slide. It is, but it is same as the previous algorithm. So here, like here, it will be now the probability I, prob I, and this equation, and the same algorithm will be updated, will be used for this global leader phase also. I hope I'm clear. In the next phase is the global leader learning phase. After the local leader phase, global leader phase, there is a phase that is called global leader learning phase, GLL phase. We will call it GLL phase. In this GLL phase, the global leader will apply the greedy selection. Means if the global leader is updated, then is updated, become better, then it, the new value is accepted. Otherwise, it is rejected. It is called the greedy selection. It is called the greedy selection, that if the global leader is updated, then the position will be updated. Otherwise, the old position will be carried over. Then spider monkeys having best fitness is selected. Then again, whatever is the new best fitness, new best solution will be referred as the global leader. But if in this phase, if this global leader is not updated, it means the scarcity of food. Scarcity of food means global leader is not updated, then there is a parameter which is called global limit count, or GLL, global limit count. It will be incremented by one. So we will start a counter here, global limit count. Global limit count is a counter. If in any iteration the solution is not updated, then this counter will be incremented by one and will keep on incrementing if the solution is not updated. Now the next phase is the local leader learning phase, because local leader phase also is completed. So local leader learning phase. In this phase, again, local leader's new position will be accepted if it is modified. If not, then the old position will be carried over, right? It is called the greedy selection. And in that particular smaller group, the monkey, whichever is the best, will be defined as the local leader. And similar like global leader learning phase, here also in that particular small group, one counter will start, which is called local limit count. So in this local limit count, if this local leader is not updated, is not updated, then this local limit count triple L will be incremented by one. So there are two counters running simultaneously. One is for the global leader and one is for the local leader, right? And same process is applied for both. So now, up till now, we have considered four phases: global leader phase, local leader phase first of all, then global leader phase, and then global leader learning phase, local leader learning phase. Now the local leader decision phase. Next phase is the decision. Based on this update and learning, there should be some decisions that has to be taken by the local leader and by the global leader, right? So I hope you remember that those decisions, actually based on this scarcity, based on this local leader limit, based on global leader limit, the local leaders and global leader has to take the decision whether these smaller groups or this entire big group is to be divided into further groups or not, or to be continued in the same group. So here in this local leader decision phase, if any local leader does not get reorganized in a particular ward known as the local leader limit, this local leader limit is actually the counter for this. Local limit count is actually the maximum value of this. That if this counter exceeds this value, local leader limit, we will define this local leader limit. This is a parameter of SpiderMonkey optimization. We will define it. There will be certain value, certain integer for this value. If this local leader local limit count acquires this local leader limit, then this phase will initiate. So then all the members of that group, this phase will not always initiate. This phase will not work always. This phase will only work if local limit count achieves this value, and this value may be 100, maybe 50, whatever. There is certain number. Then all the members of that group, that particular group, update their positions either by the random initialization or by using global leader experience, because it is understood that this local group is not updating its position. So this local group is taking the help of the global leader. So now the members of this group will update with the help of the global leader. So this time, other than all changes, instead of this local leader, in the local leader phase here, the local leader was there, but this time it is a global leader. Also, since you know that the solution is not updated up to a certain number of iterations, which is the local leader limit, therefore here, instead, this local leader will get influenced by the randomly selected member, and this randomly selected member will always be attractive. Means local leader limit will attract towards the randomly selected member because this local leader limit, local leader has lost its credibility. It is not updated. So to get out of that stagnated area, we will make this local leader move towards the randomly selected member, right? And therefore the coefficient is non-negative. Okay, so this is the equation in the local leader decision phase, which is used for the position update. So for this is the algorithm, and in this local leader phase, the same perturbation rate probability, the same perturbation rate will be used. So here I already mentioned that the solutions are updated either by the random initialization or using this equation, and therefore here you can see clearly that this, based on this probability, they will be either randomly initialized or this equation. And this phage will be initiated only if this condition is satisfied. The local limit count is greater than the local leader limit. When this counter achieves this local leader limit, only then it will be initiated. This phage will be initiated. Otherwise, this phage will not appear. Will not appear. Right? Now, the global leader decision phase. In this global leader decision phase, the position of global leader is monitored. Global leader position is monitored. Monitored means it is checked whether it is updated or not. And if it is not updated up to a certain number of iterations, then there is a parameter, one more parameter in this spider monkey optimization algorithm, which is called the global leader limit. So if it is not updated up to a certain number of iterations, that is called global leader limit, which is this counter, global limit count. So if this counter achieves this value, global leader limit, if it achieves this global leader limit, then then the global leader divides the population into smaller groups. So actually, in the natural phenomena, what happens that the initial entire group is divided into smaller groups, then the smaller groups leader will further divide that small group into smaller groups. But here in our algorithm, the rights for division of the group into further smaller groups is given to only to the global leader, So global leader only takes the decision of division into smaller groups, right? The local leader has only their decision for new update equation. If the local leader is not updated, then it will get inspiration from the global leader in this equation, will update using a new equation, but the division into smaller parts rights is only with the global leader. So here in how this global leader decision phase works, that firstly the population is divided into two groups and then three groups, so that until the maximum number of groups are achieved. And this maximum number of groups is again a parameter in this spider monkey optimization. So if you see that as compared to other swarm intelligence based algorithms, spider monkey optimization algorithm has a higher number of control parameters, which is one of the drawback of this algorithm. But all the drawback is managed, is compromised because of the accuracy this algorithm provides, because of the high efficiency and accuracy this algorithm provides. This algorithm is relatively more accurate than other swarm intelligence based algorithm, and therefore we can afford the large number of control parameters to fit to set. This population is keep on dividing into a smaller number of groups until the maximum number of groups are formed. Each time this global decision phase achieves, local leader limit local leader learning process is initiated to elect the local leader. I hope you understand that whenever this local leader decision phase will be initiated, it will make the smaller groups, and for the smaller groups you will need then the local leader. So the local leader learning phase will be initiated. Local leader learning phase means who will be the local leader, who will be the leader of that group, right? So that will be initiated. Of course, whenever you have a new group, you need the local leader. So this process will be carried out. The case in which maximum number of groups are formed and even then the position of global leader is not updated. If the global leader position is not updated and maximum number of groups are formed, then the global leader creates the fusion, combines all the groups, and this process is known as the fusion. So here the global leader is doing the fission, and here the global leader doing is the global leader is doing the fusion. So the rights of fission and fusion are only lies only with the global leader, and therefore this particular algorithm is also known as the fission fusion social structure based optimization algorithm. Okay, and this Global leader decision phase is implemented in this way. I hope I have already explained, but let us explain in the algorithmic form one more time. At this global limit count achieved, then global limit count reaches to the global leader limit, then this phase will initiate. Otherwise, this phase will not reach, right? And then global, of course, once it is reached, then the global limit count becomes zero and the phase will start. And if maximum number of groups are not formed, then divide the population into further smaller groups. If it is reached, then combine the group. Means this is your fission and this is your fusion. If the maximum number of groups are not formed, then make the fission, otherwise make the fusion. And then update the local leaders for the newly formed local groups or smaller groups. After all these six phases, this is the complete algorithm. All the phases are written here, so nothing special in this. That it, in the first of all, initialize the population. Let me just quickly summarize the algorithm. Initialize the population, local leader limit, global leader limit, perturbation rate, maximum number of groups. We need to define all these four parameters. These four parameters we need to define. So these are the four parameters which we have to define, other than the swarm size, number of monkeys in the group, swarm size, maximum number of iterations. Other than those parameters, we have to define these parameters also. And calculate the fitness, objective function value. Select the global leader, local leader based on their fitnesses. Whoever is the best in the swarm will become the global leader. Whoever is the best in that particular smaller group will become the local leader. And of course, it is based on the greedy selection. Now keep on doing this process. Finding the objective food source, generate the new solutions for all the groups by using self-experience local leader. So this is your local leader phage. Local leader phage and global leader phage. Apply the greedy selection process between existing position and newly generated position. Actually, this is nothing but all this process is nothing but 1x1 implementation of all six phases in the same order in which I explained to you, right? So in the same order, we will apply all those phases here, and that is a complete spider monkey optimization algorithm. So this is the complete spider monkey optimization algorithm, its inspiration that I explained to you. Now, just quickly, I take one more slide, which is the control parameters. What is the recommendation on the control parameters? There are four important control parameters in this SMO algorithm, which are relatively different from other swarm intelligence based algorithm. Every other swarm intelligence based algorithm has the maximum number of iterations, swarm size. So other than those, these are the four parameters which are to be set for the SMO. First is the maximum number of groups. It is usually taken as the n/10. Actually, it is considered because it is found that if the number of individuals in the particular smaller group is less than 10, then it's not a good swarm. It's not a good swarm. So to have a good swarm intelligence behavior, you should have minimum 10 members in that particular group. And therefore, we put n/10. n/10. But this is not a hard and fast. If you will take n/12, n/10, you can take n/11 or n/9. That can also work. But this one is the most recommended value. Next thing is the global leader limit. Global leader limit is the value after which the global leader will decide whether to divide, whether to make the fission or to make the fusion. So this value should be some value between this in this interval n/2, 2n. This capital N is the population size. Capital N is the population size. So suppose this population size is 100, then it will be some value between 50 to 200. So some value between 50 to 200. And if usually it is taken as equal to the swarm size. So you can take equal to 100 also. It may be smaller or larger also. It all depends upon the problem to problem. So problem to problem, this value can vary, but usually it is within this interval. Then the local leader limit. Local leader limit. This local leader limit is the value, is the threshold for the local limit count for the local limit count. So this, after this, local leader will update its position using a different update equation, and its value should be d into n. Here d is the number of decision variables in the particular optimization problem. For example, if you have a problem x1 is minimized z equal to x1 square, suppose this is your problem, minimize z equal to x1 square plus x2 square, suppose this is your problem, then here the number of decision variables are 2, and therefore d becomes 2, and here this becomes d becomes 2, and the n is suppose 100, so 2 multiplied by 100, 200, so local leader limit count is 200. So it is a relatively large value as compared to the global limit count, global leader limit, as compared to global leader limit. So global leader limit, global leader decision phase occurs more frequently than the local leader decision phase. The perturbation probability PR is some number between 0.1 to 0.9, n is the swarm size that I already explained, right? So this is the control parameters in the spider monkey optimization algorithm. Now there are a lot of theoretical analysis that how this algorithm different from other algorithm, why it works, in for what kind of problem this algorithm is good.